Wednesday healing session here at Victory Life Center. We have Pastor Barbara Oldfield and Tess and John Hainsworth here with us from Esperance. You know, we're going to get an exciting program today because I know they have powerful testimonies that are going to impact your life. And you know, both of you have powerful, exciting testimonies, which I know when people hear them today are going to, you know, touch their lives. And both of you have overcome addictions and you've been to Teen Challenge. And you've arrived here today because Pastor Anne told us a bit of a testimony, more of a recent testimony. But today we're going to start with your testimonies and how you ended up at Teen Challenge. Which of you want to start?
Oh, you can start.
John.
I grew up in a Christian home. If you were looking for the perfect home, mine was probably it. I have beautiful parents. And they took me to church. I learned about God. I have no excuses for where I ended up. When I left school, I made a series of bad choices and I got involved with people who were using drugs, and I quickly became addicted to both heroin and speed. And that lifestyle continued for about 13 years before I went to Teen Challenge.
Wow, that's... So how long ago was that?
I entered Teen Challenge in 2007.
Okay.
I had two attempts at it prior to that, but left fairly promptly. I just wasn't ready.
John, were you a city boy? Where were you brought up?
I grew up in Kalamunda.
In Kalamunda. So you're here in the city of Perth.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. And I spent 2 years at Teen Challenge, and that was just like a kickstart back into life with God. I really, in my heart, loved God, but I loved the things of the world. And over a period of 10 years, I had never really surrendered those things that I loved in the world. And so my marriage to Tess over that period slowly started to degrade.
Yeah, okay.
And I also had a lot of unforgiveness in my heart, which really came to a head when I had some confrontation at work, and I became very angry at that individual, but that also brought up a lot of the anger and bitterness that I had carried and I wasn't willing to lay down. And so very quickly, over a period of 2 years, our marriage went from what I thought was pretty good to not sure if this is actually going to work out. And we've got a beautiful daughter, and I was thinking, how will my life look if I can't see my daughter? If my story is I have a broken marriage. And Tess, over that 2 year period, had been constantly trying to point me back to Jesus and to his word, and I just, it was like a block was there. We were sitting at the kitchen table one day and she said, greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. And I said, yeah, but it sure doesn't feel like it. And shortly after that, Tess presented me with a book, which I read many times in short succession. And it reminded me of the importance of agreeing with God's word, and not only mentally agreeing, but then declaring God's word. And within probably 6 months, my life looked significantly different.
You were out of that hole.
Yeah. Yeah.
Was that book?
Yeah, the book.
Train Your Brain.
Yeah.
Which is this
that
book
was
here.
What Louise passed on to you.
Yeah.
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 So it was this book here by Pastor Margaret or Mum.
Yeah.
You know, you began to read that, and you know, put two and two together, that when you meditate on the word and you get it down in your heart, your life's transformed.
Yes, that's correct. Yeah.
So you were married to Tess. How long? So before you went to Teen Challenge, you were actually married.
We.
You met at Teen Challenge.
She,
didn't
Tess.
You?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. That's okay.
Tess was a counsellor.
I'll tell that.
Yes. Okay. Yeah.
How
no,
about you
fine.
Tell us your bit? How you ended up at Teen
Challenge? All right. Okay. Yes.
Well, my life. I came from a broken family, so there was two different worlds and. Not that I have that to blame, but I guess I just didn't have much identity and I wasn't very secure. I was very insecure, and as soon as I discovered drugs and alcohol, I felt very confident. And so from 12 years old, I was pretty much drinking and smoking pot as often as I could. And that became my reality, and I just saw life through that. And I had confidence through that, but obviously it was false confidence. But without that, I just couldn't, like, the longer it went on, without that, I couldn't bear. And I was quite suicidal for years and came to a really bad place where I discovered that Bible College was a accredited course for Centrelink, so I could go there and have it sort of covered by Centrelink if I wanted to do. So in my heart, I said to myself, okay, because I was going to very, very literally kill myself on several occasions. So I thought, well, I can kill myself or I can give this a try. And if that doesn't work, I can still kill myself after that. So I know it sounds radical and not very...
It's depression.
Yeah. The way it is, but when you're in that. So I gave Bible College a good go, and I started to experience the love of God through people, and I didn't know why they loved me and showed me kindness. And the Word of God had a huge impact in my life too, but it was the people who showed the love of God. I just discovered a whole new world and a whole new sort of window into God's heart for me.
Yeah. So do you think it's that cycle of depression was broken in Bible College?
No, actually. When I failed the first year, I decided, right, well, there's my ultimatum. I either end it or I'll try first year again. So I did first year again. And short, long story short, on that second time doing first year, at the end of the holidays, I passed it. And at the end of the holidays, I was actually getting harassed by someone from that lifestyle, and it was unsafe for me. And Pastor Anne said, do you want to come and stay with me? And so I came and stayed at her house for the holiday season, and she believed in me and respected me and saw me in a whole new light. And it really empowered me to make good choices, but still I couldn't. So I'm trying to make this quick as I can, but... I broke down because emotionally, without the drugs that suppress all that, emotionally it was too much for me to bear. Yeah. And I was in her lounge room one time, just lost it, crying. Just it hurt so much emotionally from just all a lot of bad choices along the years and things that she's like, what's wrong? I'm like, it just hurts so much. But she got me onto a counsellor who then suggested Teen Challenge, and it was presented to me that I would go for a couple of weeks for the holidays before year two Bible College. So when I got there, the story had changed. No, you have to do the program, really. Not that I had to stay, but I had no drugs to cover my emotions, and I was so raw. I thought, how can I do Bible College? Look at me. I need to be here, and I knew I needed to be there. And it was just like a turtle with its shell ripped off, just bare out there at Teen Challenge, ready to face everything. But with the love of God and with the Word of God and with the mentors there, just step by step had healing and learnt to see myself in a whole new light of who I really am in God, not who I thought I was, like bad self-esteem and all the past and stuff. So, yeah, I started to see myself, how God saw me more and more, and my heart started to grow more confident and full of hope, and I started to sort of see that I could be a normal adult and break through. Yeah.
And become a mum.
And break through the strongholds,
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
So how long was the course, Tess? Did you
Well, it took 2 years? It takes people different amounts of time.
But you didn't
took
leave.
Me 2 years.
You finished that.
I finished it.
Stayed on and became a counsellor.
I was a staff
And where
member.
You met this beautiful, handsome
Yeah, and
fellow.
We weren't. Oh. We were just friends.
Oh, of course, yes.
Yeah, all right, yes. And that's another little story.
And that's how you met. John.
Yes. And
hey, John, did you think, oh, she's quite nice straight away? Or took a while to warm up?
No, I did. It was the first time I saw her, and she was running across the oval with a backpack. And I thought, that is really interesting. I would like to get to know that person. But Teen Challenges. They have very good
rules.
Boundaries
yes.
there,
and
which
that's
is,
good
which
too.
Is yes. important and necessary. And I finished the program, and was working in town for about 12 months before Tess finished working there, and then she moved into town, and we just started hanging out.
Oh, wonderful!
Yeah, well, after I left Teen Challenge on staff, I went over to do Outward Bound in Canberra, which is outdoor recreation certificate for and. I injured myself actually through a bike accident, but all I could do was ride, funny enough, because I couldn't really walk.
Yeah, okay.
And so I decided to, in Teen Challenge, I had a dream to ride around Australia on my bike. And then, so all I could do was ride. So I thought, I'll just start this journey. And I rung my friend John in Esperance and said, would you ride across the Nullarbor with me? And he said, no. So
man,
I gave him another few weeks and I asked again and he said yes. So we ended up riding across the Nullarbor together.
That wasn't was that first to leg. Raise funds?
We named it.
You fundraised for something.
Well, no, we never ended up getting given any money or anything like that. No, because we didn't have really the skills to do all that side. But we went ahead and called it Ride for Hope and shared our testimony in places along the way. But we funded it all ourselves and we were just friends for the first stint. And I started to notice John after his performance was all sort of let go because he was so tired. I thought, this John is quite nice underneath it all. And when we got back, he asked me to date and we started dating and, we
That's
got
awesome.
Married.
But it's awesome, isn't it, to see lives restored.
Yeah.
You both were on the path to destruction.
Yeah. Yeah.
God had other plans and turned those lives, and it's not over yet, obviously.
Yeah.
Lots ahead for both of you.
Yeah.
Because your stories will help others. There may be people watching today that are in addictions and and some of the things you did to get out will be what they will need to do.
Yeah, it's true. And, you know, it's just encouraging. And so 9 months ago you were having marriage issues, which is kind of how you ended up here today. And someone gave you this book, was that right, Train Your Brain?
Tess gave me the book.
Tess gave you the book because you were going through issues. And then you began to read this and in the back there's actually scriptures. Yeah. Sorry, I don't have two. Someone can read a couple of the scriptures out of the back. But... just in that book, it changed your life. It impacted you through the words, you know, that are in there. And I'm not sure if there's a bit that stands out to you in this book here, Train Your Brain. But I just know that, you know, it's touched so many people's lives. And, you know, it's about right thinking.
Yeah.
And so that's what both of you've done. You've renewed your minds at Teen Challenge.
And this book, of course, is available here at the bookshop. And we highly recommend it. Even doctors, psychologists have said that's an excellent book. From a true champ, because you have to train your brain to win Wimbledon like she did.
Yeah.
If anyone knows how to train the brain in the Word of God, it's your mum or Pastor Margaret.
Yeah, that's
true. And it's a great book. So people need to know that it is available here. They can come in and get it.
Yeah, they can.
So what was one of those scriptures, John?
Whatever is pure and lovely and worthy of praise, think on these things. Mm. It's very easy to not be aware of what you're thinking about or just to think about whatever you want to think about. And I was very good at that, and I really had to learn to be diligent to catch myself when I would go down the bunny trails that were so ingrained in my thinking of anger towards certain individuals or just really seething bitterness.
Do you want to tell that experience, how you prayed in tongues and the power of praying in tongues as well?
Well, I mean, when we're at Teen Challenge, we would read the Bible, a chapter of the Bible at every meal time, and then we'd have question time. And I remember one time we had read the scripture about where Jesus said to Peter, you know, do you want to leave as well? And Peter said, well, where are we going to go? You alone have the words of life. Mm. And Tess made a comment on that, and I remember it clearly to this day, and I thought, you know what? It took me a long time to actually get there in my own thinking, but I have tried the things that the world offers, and I have held on to them tightly, thinking, I know that it didn't come through for me that time, but maybe next time it will. And I know, after 15 years of being out of Teen Challenge, I finally understand that only Jesus has the words of life. And it's only when you live life His way does life really work and is really worth living. I too have had several suicide attempts and have understood that when someone says life doesn't feel like living, I understand. And when I was very angry and bitter, in just recently,
9 months ago.
Nine months ago, before you read that book, yeah.
I was battling with what one particular individual had done to me, and I felt like God was saying, you know, you need to forgive them. And I said to God, I am not going to forgive them. They can go to hell for all I care. And I was really genuine. I thought, this person can rot in hell. I want them to go to hell. I want them to pay. I want them to suffer. And as soon as I had declared that in my heart, I could feel this evil presence coming through the room toward me, and it scared me. And I started praying in tongues, and nothing. And I still felt this presence coming towards me, and I was really genuinely scared. And I kept praying in tongues, and I felt the presence back off, and then it would try and come toward me again. And when you say it, it sounds kind of kooky, but this God is spirit, and the spiritual world is real.
Yeah.
And it was a good reminder for me that my battle is not against people. There are people who hurt me. There are people who have hurt. We're all a victim of
from people. Our battle is against principalities and powers, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, there's a spirit that motivates people. And you, like, remember when the disciples said to the Lord, call down fire burn them. And Jesus says, you don't know what spirit you're of. Mm. And so that was a correction there. Mm. And as you know, God is not against any human, but there is a spirit behind people that motivates them and to bring them to a point of destruction. Mm. Well, a spirit of suicide is one of those. Mm. That's a very, you know, you're talking about people in drugs and alcohol, and the link to that is often, I didn't want to live. I don't want to live anymore. I want to kill myself. Why is that? Because the spirit behind it is a destructive. It's a spirit, you know, the devil wants to kill you. Mm. And he will do anything in his power. And when he gets enough drugs into you, alcohol, you're out of your right mind. Mm. And so he can take that. So
he's out to steal, kill, and destroy.
Yeah.
But it's interesting, John, because you actually spoke those words about that person, and then you felt that spirit coming against you. So it was the words of your mouth that opened the door to that spirit to come against you. But then you began to pray in the Holy Ghost and you pushed it back. But it wasn't until you read the book that you got totally free of that.
Well, the book had a lot of really important reminders about what the importance of what you meditate on, the importance of declaring the truth over your life. What I thought was, when things started to improve, beauty, we've got this nailed, it's over, you know, happy days from now. What I have since realized is it's so important to be diligent to maintain what God has obtained.
It's an ongoing
thing, and probably in the last month I could see old thought patterns coming back in, and I really had to be diligent about being good soil. It's very easy to deceive yourself and think, if nobody knows about this, then it's okay, I can get away with it. If I can still maintain some sort of semblance of normal, I'm getting away with it. But even, it's true, God is not mocked. We reap what we sow. And if we sow negative thoughts, we reap anger, we reap fear.
It's a big call to stay in the Word 24/7. You don't really have the luxury of not having this Word in you, driving your car, on your way to work, you know, everything. You really should have the Word, you know, let the Word dwell in you richly, abundantly. You know, just every day, it's a great day. Thank the Lord. Be grateful.
Yeah, that's what testing. You became a mentor at Teen Challenge, didn't you?
Yeah.
And that was just through renewing your mind?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind just sharing the fact that a major breakthrough came in my life with the suicide and everything. It was like a deep-rooted self-hatred. And I think a lot of people maybe listening might have that as well. Who knows? But I had to break that stronghold, because I had let the enemy in that, and it was like a stronghold. I had to do a lot of renouncing. And so I prayed with my mentor when I was still a student, and I prayed against a lot of the things I had let in and said, you know, just from my teenagehood into the occult and things like that as well. And I had to renounce and break a lot of that. And seriously, I remember being at the backyard of the Teen Challenge house and looking at the clothesline just randomly and thinking, oh, I'm actually okay. I've got no substances. I'm fine. I feel fine, you know, and it was like, wow.
You got
and
set
from
free.
The, yeah, it was a setting
the
free.
The curse was broken because you actually broke it with the words of your mouth when you renounced it.
Yeah.
You were redeemed
from
the curse.
Well, wanting to die is the ultimate self-curse.
Mm.
Wanting to die, I don't want to live. That's what the devil wants in that hatred, as you say, Tess, of yourself.
Yeah.
No self-image, no self-worth. I'm better off dead. No one really loves me. No one really cares. Mm. And he'll pile on wrong thoughts, and all of those are not true. That's not true. And so that's a big curse, self-cursing, self-hatred. Yeah. No, we need to love ourselves, not in the hedonistic way, but in a way, God didn't make junk. He made me. Yeah. He loves me and He cares about me. Yeah. And I reckon that's a big key to people's healing, to know most people love God to the ability, but they don't know how much I believe God loves them.
Yeah.
And you two are now parents. You've got a beautiful little girl. We just met her. And we have another little one on the way. How beautiful. Yeah. But you are parents now and you've stepped into another dimension. Yeah. It's no longer you. You've got a little life that's dependent on you. But God is a better father and a mother than all of us. Yeah. And His desire for us is, what do you want for your little girl? You want a blessing. Yeah. You'd never want her to be feeling, I'm not worthy, I'm not, So when we really know Daddy, we really know His love, it'll shift you. Yeah. And to shift people is a big key, that you're worth loving. Yeah. God loves you. Yeah. And He's got a good plan.
Well, Tess would have had to do that. So you renounced it all and then you would have had to fill yourself up with the Word of God, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you would have just spoken the words about God loving you.
And there's a whole list of things from, I've forgotten his name, but it's all the scriptures written out in the back of his book about who I am in Christ.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I would meditate on that. I'd have them all over my wall.
I'm the head and not the tail. I'm more than a conqueror.
And so I just meditated a lot on all of that and got a new outlook on
everything.
I'm
made in the image of
God. The power of the word as
well.
I'm
a new creation in Christ Jesus. All of those ones.
All things are passed away.
Yeah. And you would have just spoken those on a regular basis. Mm-hmm. Build yourself up with the word of God.
Yep.
So if that's you out there and you've had that struggle with those self-hatred thoughts or those suicide thoughts, you know, it's the word of God. I've had to do that in my own life because I didn't like myself. I've had to renew my mind and put those exact same scriptures that you're talking about in my own heart on a daily basis, on a regular basis. Every time the enemy comes with a lie, what do you say? No, I'm a new creation in Christ Jesus. Old things have passed away. All things have become new. Mm. I don't have to listen to that anymore. That's the past. It's done away with. And, you know, we all have to put the word in on a regular basis because the enemy, as you said before, is out to steal, kill and destroy.
He'll take it.
So, you know, we just got to keep applying that word of God and putting it into our hearts
and
on a
daily
basis.
It's what comes out of your mouth.
Yeah.
You don't...
Yeah.
It's what you say and if it's linked...
That shapes you.
Yes, and it shapes you. You step into the words of your mouth. Even like you might say, I'm going to go to the shops now. And you go to the shops. Your mouth precedes what you're feeling. The devil listens and knows, locates you. So if you can start speaking not from the soulish realm, I want, I think, I feel, rather than no, I'm going to say what he says about me.
Yes.
And
yes.
And that's a good parent too. You know, your child may say something, say, no, darling, you're beautiful. Mummy, I'm not pretty. You're beautiful.
Yeah.
You know, if we can come against... Because a child, everyone grows up in inferiority a lot. You know, I'm not as good as others and all this. So it's a real task to say, no, you're precious and you're valuable and you're unique. Mm. You know, there's no daughter like your daughter.
No.
There's no one like her in the whole world.
Mm.
And there's no one like each of us either. You know, God made each person. And Teen Challenge is a wonderful place and highly recommend it, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
For anyone at home, you know, that's, you know, got people in...
It's teen and adult challenge. It's like any age.
It's any age, isn't it?
Yes. Adults.
Yes.
Yeah. It's not just drugs.
Yeah, well, we quite often work with Teen Challenge from church. We'll send people when they come off the streets, we'll send them to Teen Challenge.
Mm.
And also when they come out of Teen Challenge, quite a lot of them will come to Perth. And to fit back in to society, they'll go to Bible college. So usually majority of people do it the other way around. But Tess, you know, what an awesome testimony you have.
Yeah.
You know, God got you there through this door, got you down there to restore your
life.
I had
to be removed from all my contacts.
Yeah.
Really.
And that's a very common, you know, scenario with people who've been addicted to drugs.
And also here on a Thursday night, we have Brad, who's also come out of that drug-addicted place. And we have a wonderful ministry there Thursday nights here.
VOA, Victory Over Addiction.
Victory Over Addiction. I love that. Victory. Speak victory.
Yeah.
You can break it. You can come through. Anyone can that. God has a desire to bring you through.
Yeah,
so I love that. So there's a Thursday night program that anyone listening, you know, they can make inquiries and come along, 7 o'clock, isn't it, on a Thursday night.
And you can get this book in the bookshop that John talked about. You can get that online as well. It's called Train Your Brain by Margaret Court. And in that book, it's got, you know, scriptures at the back there that you can speak over your own life, you know, about I have not been given a spirit of fear, but a power and love and a sound mind, because a lot of what we've talked about is fear-based as well. Mm-hmm. So that's a powerful scripture in the Bible. If you've ever had, you know, a stronghold or an addiction, because once it's removed, then all the fear and the torment comes. So that scripture's in there. There's many key scriptures in there to renew your mind and to change your life. But we're going to take this opportunity to pray for anyone out there right now. If that's you, if you've been in a struggle and you've struggled with an addiction, you guys, if you have something on your heart to pray for the people listening today, we would love you to pray. But we're just going to pray for anyone out there. So, Father, we just thank you, Lord. Anyone listening today, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we just thank you for total healing and total restoration to their life, Father. Lord, where they've had self-hatred or haven't liked themselves, Father, I thank you that you just touch their life today. You just pour your spirit out on them right now and comfort them, Lord Jesus, that they know how much you love them, Father. I just thank you for freedom in their life right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I just thank you, Lord Jesus, that nothing is impossible for you, that you're turning their life around for good. Mm. And I just thank you for it right now in Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Mm. I just pray for a shift of your mind. Shift that mindset. You can make it. You can come through. Mm. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I'm well able to do this because Jesus is in my boat. We're going to row to the other side together. And Father God, I just thank you that anyone out there who's feeling hopeless and feels they need to drink, they need to take a drug to cope with their life, we pray that be broken, that mindset be broken today. Lord, touch them in a mighty way. Whisper that you love them. Mm. Tell them they're loved. And Father, we just thank you today that they begin this journey. And it may be a journey for you, that they come, seek help, come into the Bible school, into the addiction program, seek out help, whether it be a teen challenge, but there is help available and they will find it because you promised if you will find me if you seek me with all your heart. Mm.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
you. Either of you got anything you want to pray?
Well, I just pray, Lord, that even if the people listening might think, well, I don't really want to change right now, like I'm not wholehearted, I haven't hit rock bottom or whatever, Lord, even if they want to, I pray that would be enough. If you want to change, that would be enough. And you'd hold on to that, Lord, that they would hold on to that. And you would help them to shift from wanting to want to wanting to changing, to finding the avenue, to seek your word and receive it into their heart, whatever the avenue would be, Lord. You would move them into that space of change and new beginnings, Lord. Even if they can't see themselves as a different person, Lord, I pray that you would help them to start to see themselves the way you see them, and that they are whole, and that they are healed, and that they can be happy, and that they can have peace, and that they can have breakthrough, and you can heal them physically and emotionally and mentally, and just give them a job and a life, Lord, and a hope. You can fix it all. You're a great God and you can do it all. They don't need to know how to do everything. Lord, I pray that they would just come to you and say, yes, please help me. Yes, and I ask this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah,
thank you.
You know, and if there's anyone out there today and you don't know Jesus, we're going to say a prayer together and you can ask Jesus into your heart today, if that's you. Just like, you know, when you ask Jesus into your heart, it totally transforms and changes your life. So if that's you out there today, just say these words after me. Dear Jesus,
Dear Jesus,
I believe in my heart.
I believe in my heart
that God raised Jesus from the dead.
That God raised Jesus from the dead.
This is a new day.
This is a new day.
A new beginning.
A new beginning.
And a fresh start.
And a fresh start.
And I'll follow you.
And I'll follow you
all the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You know, if that's you and you've said that for the very first time, we have a little book we'd love to send you. So give us a call, drop us an email. You can come in person and have a chat to someone. You know, if that's you and this testimony today has touched your life, we'd love to be a part of your life and be a part of getting free. So you can come in and visit the church. You know, give us a call. We have a prayer centre that's open 5 days a week and there's people sitting there waiting to pray with you. So I know God can set you free, just like these two beautiful people here. Thanks for coming and being with us today. You know, they've been set free, they're redeemed. God's turned their marriage around through the word of God. And I just know it's a powerful testimony. And if he's done it for them, he can do it for you, even if it's just you're saying, I'm not addicted to all those things, I just smoke. Well, you know what? God wants you free from smoking too. Anything. He wants us totally free. In every area of our lives.
What is it? Someone said, smoking it won't send you to hell, but it makes you smell like you've been in hell. I love that. Yeah, but he can do the impossible.
Yeah.
And I believe Tess even had trouble getting pregnant again, and now you're pregnant.
Mm.
And we didn't get to that part of the testimony.
Well,
but
we can share that now.
But when God does a work, doesn't he do a work?
Yeah.
Isn't he beautiful?
Yeah. Yeah.
He doesn't leave part of you untouched. He wants the whole person.
Yeah. So she was stressed out because of the marriage wasn't good. And as soon
very
as
stressful.
John got set very stressed out. Yeah. And as soon as John got set free, then she got free,
and then pregnant
again.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
And it was affecting your body, you said.
I had a stress rash. I was like to the end of myself, really. I had come away. I had to come away out of the house. I came to Perth for 2 weeks, and so things got darker at home, but anyway, I was having a nice time with Ocean and just away from everything for a while, wondering where to next, really, but saying, God, I'm not going to move without, you know, your support. But meanwhile, God was working on John, and I came back to a different man. His face was blah, and when I came back, it had lifted.
Yeah.
He's changed and it's consistent.
Yeah.
I was skeptical at first. I was like, all right, give it time. I know what happens, but I didn't want to be too skeptical. But it's been 9 months and he has consistently changed. God has healed him. And meanwhile, my stress rash went and my reproductive system came back to life.
Came back to normal?
Yeah. Yeah.
Isn't that awesome? Yeah. Isn't that awesome?
Powerful.
And just we just have a sister or a brother for our first child, which is my desire, which I thought I had to let go of.
Yeah.
But God's healed not only him and me, our family, and the hope for our family.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And well, I believe a ministry, guys. God hasn't brought you this far, and I'll prophesy over you right now. All you've been through is for a, there's a lot more coming.
Yeah.
Seek God with all your hearts. He's restored you as a family, but you're going to minister out of this restoration place. You're going to help so many people. Because just like you said, John, I understand when you say, I don't want to live. Yeah. I've been there.
Yeah.
I've been there. Yeah. There's nothing better than having a ministry where you say, I can help you get out because I was in. Now I'm out.
Yeah.
So seek God with that, won't you? Because I'm looking forward to great things, hearing great things.
And before we go, I just know that, John, do you want to pray for the men that are listening today that have struggled with depression? Because I just feel there's, you know, it's on your life. You've been set free and, you know, God turned your marriage around. You can pray for marriages too if you want, because I just know there's people out there that need prayer right now.
Yeah, especially men.
Yeah, well, Lord, I thank you, first of all, for making me a man. Lord, you don't make any mistakes. And thank you, Lord, for the vital role that women play. But I thank you also for the vital role that men play, Lord.
Yes,
and I just want to speak your word, Lord, over any men that are hearing my voice right now, that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a spirit of power, love and a sound mind. God, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I feel that men take a great burden upon themselves to be a good provider, a good husband, a good father, and it's so easy to feel like a failure. And God says, you're not a failure. I walk with you. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his way. Though he fall, he will not be utterly cast down,
Amen.
For the Lord upholds him with his hand.
Amen.
And I just want to encourage men in Jesus' name that God does not give up on you, that yes, you will fail, but God does not give up on you, and that it is so important for the lives of your family, of your the family that God has for you in the future, that you get up again and you know, do not stay down, but that you rise again and you turn your eyes on Jesus and you say, you are my source. You are my hope.
Yes, Lord.
Where does my help come from? My help comes from you, God. You alone.
Amen.
And I can testify that God's word is life and health to all our flesh. And
yes, Lord.
I thank you, God, that that there is power in your word, that there is life in your word, that your life, that your word does transform our mind and our life. And I thank you, God, for not giving up on us and for causing us to rise again. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. What a powerful anointed prayer. The anointing's here while you're praying, John.
Yes.
So thank you so much for that prayer, and I'm sure it's touched people out there. Thank you so much for joining us today. It's been great having you with us. You know, you can go back and listen to previous weeks, but I just know today would have touched people's lives. If you've had depression or oppression,
Amen.
You know, you can listen to this over and over and know that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And have an awesome week, and we love you.
Bye.
Bye.